Father, release upon me to do your things first in the name of Jesus. Father, release that grace upon me in the name of Jesus. The grace to satisfy your church, Father, release on me in Jesus' mighty name. We are praying. I want to pray. You know, every day you sleep and you wake up, it's a what? A new day, a new dawn. So you want to pray for yourself this afternoon. You will say, Father, help me to arise daily and shine for your glory in the name of Jesus. Almighty God, help me to arise daily and shine for your glory in the name of Jesus. King of glory, help me to arise daily and shine for your glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord of hosts, help me to arise daily and shine for your glory in Jesus' mighty name. We have prayed. Now, I told you a story of the book that I've not read, but I have. It says, I am better than this. When you wake up every day and you tell yourself, no matter what I've achieved, Lord, I am better than this, it will spoil you into action for that day. It will open your eyes of understanding to one area of your life where you need to make an improvement and become a better person. And that is why you want to pray this prayer. Say, Father, take me to a mountain that is higher than I, in the mighty name of Jesus. On a daily basis, Lord, take me to that mountain that is higher than I, in the name of Jesus. Spiritually, Lord God, mighty, ministerially, in my career, in my business, in my endeavors, every area of my life. Father, take me to a mountain that is higher than I, every day. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
You want to pray? You say, Father, I am better than this. Please help me to arise and shine in the name of Jesus. Almighty God, I am better than this. My condition is better than this. Help me to arise and shine for your glory on a daily basis in the name of Jesus. Help me, Lord, to arise and shine in Jesus' mighty name. We are praying.
Amen.
Finally, before you pray this prayer point, the Lord asks you to tell somebody. You may be going through immigration challenges. You may be having challenges. You may not be able to do the kind of work you want to. You cannot even walk. The Lord says, I should tell you, why don't you use the time when you are trying to perfect your challenges to begin to do online courses, to begin to improve yourself. So when the paper comes, you would have been ready to get fantastic jobs. You see, somebody once told us, it's a miracle. A miracle happens when opportunity jams preparation. When opportunity jams preparation, you cannot prepare. When the opportunity comes, you will not see it. That was why the man, the blind man, on the way out of Jericho, you know his name? Bartimaeus. He was the son of a big man, according to Hebrew. When you have history, they will call your name and call the name of your father. So Bartimaeus means Timaeus. I mean, didn't Bar the son of Timaeus or something? So he was the son of Timaeus. So he had a father, but he was a disgrace to the family. Because of told, they put him on the edge of the city. And the Bible recorded that was the last time that Jesus was passing through Jericho. Jesus never came back to Jericho after that day. And people were following him. Before him, did you hear of any other miracle that day? Jesus came because of him. But Jesus would not say, because I came because of you, I must come to you to give you a miracle. It's not, doesn't work like that all the time. You will be the one who will attract your miracle. By your preparation, you will attract your miracle. So the man, I'm sure what the man was telling himself every day of his life was, I'm not going to die a blind man. Even though I was born blind, but I refused to die a blind man. So every day he was begging for money. His ears was alert. He couldn't see, but he developed his ears. You know, there's some people who are deficient in one area of life, that the other senses are always more active. I don't know how true it is, but I've heard that many times. So I want to believe that because the guy could not see, his ears could pick up any sound. Because if not for that, and that is why preparation and opportunity comes in. That day, the same people were walking out. Jesus was already going, crowd were following him, and like as a celebrity. But the man knew something. He knows that the kind of sound of legs that he was hearing was more ordinary than usual. And that is where preparation comes in. He had it at the back of his mind, he would not die blind. So he had positioned his ear to catch any sound that goes around him that his eyes cannot see. So that day, he actually realized that there were many people walking through this lonely road. This is not a road that is well traveled. Why, how come suddenly I can hear so many people walking? And then he comes and said, come. I said, why is there so much? I said, is Jesus passing by? Eh? Remember what we know the rest of the story. He started shouting, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. That was how his miracle came. His miracle came because he was prepared. He had made up his mind that any day that he comes across Jesus, his eyes must open. He want to pray. Final prayer point. Say, Father, I will not miss the opportunity on the day of my miracle in the mighty name of Jesus. As I trust you, as I believe in you, that I will rise and shine. I will not miss my opportunity on the day my miracle comes in the mighty name of Jesus. I will not miss my opportunity in the name of Jesus. I will not miss my opportunity in the mighty name of Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Father, prayer point for your church. We say, Father, our church is better than this. Please help us to arise and shine and be more relevant in St. Thomas, in Nottingham, and in the United Kingdom, in the mighty name of Jesus. Prayer.